right now. Scott Hall backstage. Here's what I'm being told by no less than Scott Hall, Mike, today. He said that he is going to have an announcement that he will make in the ring about why we haven't seen the Giant. Now, he told me why. What I'm going to do is see if he tells the fans of WCW and NWO the same story that he told me.
Well, he's wearing both of the tag belts. He's got the omnipresent beverage in his hand.
The what?
The omnipresent beverage. Wow. Everywhere this guy goes.
Are you getting a check from the Omnipresent Beverage Company? Is that the deal? Must be. Scott Hall makes his way to the ring. I can tell you, this will be a tag team title match.
You spoke with JJ?
Talked to James J. Dillon backstage. The titles are on the line here, regardless of what Scott Hall has to say in the ring. He can't talk his way out of a title defense here on Saturday night. The contracts have been let, and this time I want Pinzer to give up the mic.
Let's get the explanation straight from Scott Hall.
One half of the tag team champs with the live mic on Saturday. Hold your breath.
Hey, yo. Somebody said they were having a party on Saturday night. And if you've noticed, Scott Hall don't miss no parties lately.
Huh?
And a lot of people have a problem with that. But somebody told me that in the Constitution, we all agree that we dig the USA, that you're guaranteed life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness. So anybody who don't like it, try to stop me.
Well, he's consistent so far.
So that leads me to the guy who's been bossing me around, or trying to, for the last 8 years, Big Sexy Kevin Nash. Well, Kev, to prove to you and to everybody else that no matter what kind of shape I am, I always carry our team.
What?
And you know it. So I gave G Money, the Giant, the night off, because I'm going to wrestle these two J Bros by myself.
He said.
And Kev.
That's the explanation?
I want you to remember this, because Havoc's coming up and me and you are going to get it on. Being the biggest don't make you the best. The survey says being the best makes you the best. And if you don't like it, you can meet me down there.
Handicap tag title match is next.
Well, this is going to be quite a test for Scott Hall. He is going to defend the World Tag Team titles against two men, a handicap match. He's given the Giant off. I guess this is his way to prepare for battle, and it is upcoming next Sunday at Halloween Havoc when he has to go into the ring against Big Sexy, the 7-footer Kevin Nash.
Well, Scott Hall was remarkably consistent in what he said when he came to the ring. What he told me was he has to face Kevin Nash at Halloween Havoc, and that Kevin Nash is as big as two men. Thus, he gives the Giant the night off. I didn't know he could do that. The Giant given the night off by Scott Hall, so Scott Hall could prepare to wrestle a man the size of Kevin Nash 1 week from tomorrow night at Halloween Havoc. Thus, it's Scott Hall defending the tag team titles against two men in disorderly conduct.
Well, he was remarkably consistent, and he was maybe even more remarkably lucid while he was delivering that interview.
Unbelievable.
Looks like he's in fine condition to go against disorderly conduct tonight.
He has to be. These are two tough men in Mean Mike and Tough Tom.
Now let's see, that's Mean Mike in the ring right now.
Mean Mike in the ring, and Scott Hall, well, actually missing with the toothpick challenge. Gonna take a second shot at it. That one worked. Now Scott Hall calling in Mean Mike, collar and elbow tie up. into the wrist lock on Mean Mike's shoulder into the chest, and another. Scott Hall tried to soften him up. What exciting news we heard earlier about Thunder this Thursday. The return of Rey Mysterio Jr., Mike, today. One of the most popular cruiserweight champions, one of the most popular wrestlers in the history of WCW, comes back to the fold Thursday on Thunder.
People have been asking me for the past several months when Rey Jr. was going to return to WCW action. We understand that he had scope knee surgery, fully rehabbed. He claims he's going to be back 100% when he goes into the ring in Albuquerque this upcoming Thursday on Thunder. Also, speaking of Thunder, we have tickets on sale right now in Roanoke, Virginia for Thunder on November the 5th, as well as Fort Wayne, Indiana on November the 19th. In Roanoke, we're at the Civic Center. In Fort Wayne, at the Allen County Memorial Coliseum. Tickets available at both of the respective arena box offices and Ticketmaster for Thunder in Roanoke and Fort Wayne.
Well, nothing beats WCW action live and in person. You don't want to miss it. As Mean Mike, that's Tough Palm, rather, putting the boot across the throat of Scott Hall. Scott Hall cannot make the tag. Looked like he was looking for a tag team partner in the Giant. There's no Giant, Scott. This was your idea.
Well, disorderly conduct, certainly no strangers to tag team wrestling. That's their primary focus as far as their wrestling careers go. So this is the perfect situation for them.
Tough Tom in there across the back of Scott Hall. Cover, Tough Tom, lateral press on Scott Halling at the two count. A night of champions on the Superstation here on Saturday night. Kidman retaining the Cruiserweight Championship. Chris Jericho barely retaining the Television Championship. And Scott Hall solely defending the tag team titles against disorderly conduct and exerting himself pretty well.
Well, seeing him unload with those big right hands, I'm not going to question whether he's in any shape or any condition to compete. He's proving it to us tonight.
Scott Hall looking tougher than ever, taking on two men as he has given the Giant the night off. That explains why we never saw the Giant backstage. And he's kind of hard to miss, as we said earlier. Scott Hall, fall away slam, overhead release, and Scott Hall catches Tough Tom. Oh, that's Mean Mike, rather, with the choke slam.
Down goes Mean Mike, so even in his absence, he's representing the Giant.
Not a bad Giant impersonation, actually, by Scott Hall, as disorderly conduct are both out. Scott Hall better pin somebody. Uh-oh, there's the sign.
Who's he going to pick for the edge?
I don't know. They're not lining up for it. They're not raising their hands, volunteering to be put up in the outsider's edge. Scott Hall asking the crowd, who do they want to see up in the edge?
Can we even call it the outsider's edge any longer with the split of the outsider's tag team and the fact that it's all going to come to a head 1 week from tomorrow at Halloween Havoc when he goes into the ring against Kevin Nash?
Here we go. That's Mean Mike up in the outsider's edge from Scott Hall.
Oh!
On the back of the head.
Oh, Tough Tom also?
2-for-1 Outsider's Edge special here on Saturday night. Scott Hall sets Tough Tom up. Oh, powers him up.
These are two big athletes.
Into the Outsider's Edge.
The double edge from Scott Hall.
Now what? Oh, could be the double pin.
Gonna stack them up.
Not a textbook cover, but the three count nonetheless, and Scott Hall successfully defends the World Tag Team Championships over disorderly conduct. He's ready for Halloween Havoc.
That is one thing that's very evident. Scott Hall is prepared for Halloween Havoc, and in my eyes, he has just sent a message to Kevin Nash.
Big Sexy the Giant Killer, watch that one with interest. No question, what a night it's been on Saturday night. A championship Saturday, highlighted by Scott Hall retaining the tag team straps. Fans, they will hook up at Havoc. Let's take a look at DDP and Goldberg.